Hello and happy Tuesday, which is of course my book reviews day. And today I would like to talk to you about The Little Sleep by Paul Tremblay, while also showcasing two different editions for this. If you know the name Paul Tremblay, it's likely from his horror novels from the past few years. But his first ever published novel was actually a crime novel. It was a detective novel, The Little Sleep, featuring his private eye, Mark Genovich, or Genovich? I'm going to go with Genovich. He is almost an anti-private eye in a way. He is a narcoleptic private eye. He has difficulty staying awake. He's falling asleep in just the absolute worst circumstances and worst times. While he is asleep, he's having vivid hallucinations. While he's awake, while he's asleep and going through the motions, he's encountering people who think he's awake, and then he will actually wake up and have no recollection of the conversation. Let's say he's like an anti-private eye in a way. So I have two editions to showcase here while I'm talking about the book. I'll go into more details of them after the book review proper, but we do have our SST edition from overseas in the UK featuring the artwork of Danielle Serra, and we have the US oversized limited edition from Thunderstorm Books featuring Dust Jacket artwork by Ben Baldwin. But anyways, let's talk about the book itself. It begins with Mark Genovich conversing with a woman in his office, the woman on the cover here, who is tasked our good private eye with finding out whoever stole her fingers. Her fingers were stolen and replaced with somebody else's fingers. And, well, Mark wakes up to realize that he has just had one crazy dream. But not everything was a dream, because in front of him are some incriminating photos of the woman that he just dreamt of. So he has no recollection of the conversation that led to him having these photographs. And so it's almost a detective thriller in reverse. Before he can solve the case, he has to figure out what the case even is. And, well, it's going to take him down a rabbit hole that involves a little bit of corruption, a little bit of mystery, a little bit of his Lithuanian mother in her clown pants, which is shown right here. Ellen, his mother, is as supportive as she could possibly be, helping him pay for his rent for his office and his apartment above the office as he tries to make a name for himself as a PI. And I'm not going to lie, he is a terrible PI, but that's what makes this such a fascinating read. I mean, even the title, The Little Sleep, is a nod to The Big Sleep by Raymond Chandler. And the whole novel is like a nod to those classic private eyes. He has the smarmy smartass dial cranked up to 11, almost to a point where it seems detrimental to his own private eye work. You know, somebody who... There are people he's going to encounter that may or may not deal with the case. He doesn't know what the case is. He's trying to put it together. It's clearly got to be some sort of blackmail case involving, you know, these scandalous photos. But as he's encountering people that could possibly help with the case, he is very quick to give a smart-ass response. Everything that happens to him has a smart-ass response. So almost to the point where, like I said, it's detrimental to his investigative career. It's almost baffling, like, how he can be a private eye with just how difficult of a person he can be. It's almost like Genovich read one too many Raymond Chandler novels, or read one too many of perhaps a Kenzie and Gennaro novel with Dennis Lehane, and said, you know what, I can do that by cranking the smarminess up to 11 and just being difficult. But it is a very fascinating read, and I'm not going to lie, it's definitely one you should check out. Not necessarily if you're a fan of Paul Tremblay, because if you're coming into this looking for a horror novel, you're going to be disappointed. But if you're coming into it looking for a very fun and very interesting take on the noir detective novel, then this is definitely one that you are going to have a blast with. or at least I think you'll have a blast with. The man loves his similes. Similes and metaphors. He has similes and metaphors in abundance. There are, you know, if you've read a million detective novels before, you might see some of the twists coming. But thankfully, Jenovich, being an unreliable narrator, primarily due to the fact that he's unreliable to himself because of his narcolepsy, it adds some levels of mystery and intrigue that kept me guessing at times. I mean, like I said, he has difficulty staying awake. When he does fall asleep, he can have almost like, you know, a sleep at the wheel kind of conversations with people he doesn't remember. He has hallucinations that prove to be unreliable. And it's just, man, it's a wild, wild story for the, in those regards. The additions themselves, which I've kind of been showing and flipping through as I've been talking about the book here, are very different editions. I mean, the novel proper is the same within each. Within SST, you do get the very nice cloth binding, whereas you have the kind of bonded leather, fake leather binding of the Thunderstorm edition. The Thunderstorm edition does not have any interior illustrations. It just has Ben Baldwin's cover artwork featuring a guy that kind of looks like Dominic Cooper. You know, you have your fedora-wearing Mark Jenovich, who's always wearing a fedora because he has some ugly scars underneath from a prior accident. You only see one eye on the cover here, but he's described as having one eye slightly lower than the other or slightly higher than the other because of his accidents. Daniel Serra actually provides both the cover artwork as well as interior illustrations, which I've shown within the SST edition, which is really cool. Both editions actually have their own exclusive pieces from Paul Tremblay. He has an afterword in the SST edition, which is very interesting. Kind of talks about, there's the acknowledgments, which are the same. The acknowledgments are in the back of the SST edition, but the front of the Thunderstorm edition, which is very nice. The bonus material, you have your afterword, talking about after the fact, 14 years after the fact, kind of what it was like with him writing this novel. It deals with kind of his research delving into various noir detective crime fiction, especially because he's an author who didn't come from crime fiction. It also has a bonus. I feel like this was written by somebody else. Let me see here. I feel like this was a piece that was written by another author, not him. But I can't recall, and I don't see a person's name on this, so maybe it was him. Maybe it was a piece that he wrote about Weird Boiled or Noired, which is a combination of noir and the hard-boiled detective fiction. It also has a playlist, both for his own inspiration while writing this, as well as Mark Jenovich's playlist for within it, which is very interesting. Very cool addition. Little Sleep, the Thunderstorm edition, apart from having the beautiful end papers that Thunderstorm is known for. As I said, they do have the acknowledgments up front. But then you have a different afterword, once again talking about the history of the novel, what it was like writing the novel. And then it also has a little short story of a sort. This is kind of where the novel began. I guess I lied. It's not an afterword. It must be a foreword in this. Acknowledgements. Introduction. Yeah, I lied. It's an introduction in this, talking about him writing it. But Chance the Dick is in the Thunderstorm edition, which is like a short story. It's like a little conversational piece. It starts off with basically describing where the novel was born from. It was born from a scene that he pictured of the woman missing her fingers. Eventually the details come in later, like the details of him being narcoleptic, which explains why he had such a vivid hallucination of a woman losing her fingers. I'm not going to lie, the short story, if you want to call it that, actually felt very Josh Malerman-esque. The novel itself didn't feel like Malerman. The novel itself, if anything, kind of reminded me of Kenzie and Gennaro, Dennis Lehane's novels, which are superb. If you want incredible crime fiction, which is just standalone crime fiction without, you know, narcoleptic twist, then you definitely should check out the Kenzie and Gennaro books from Dennis Lehane. But The Little Sleep manages to provide a great twist on the hard-boiled detective story, which made a very interesting read. I'm going to be moving on next to No Sleep Till Wonderland, his second novel. So if you want to watch a book review and comparison video for the second novel, please subscribe to the channel here. I have at least one book review a week on Tuesdays, plus plenty of unboxing videos in between those, so plenty to keep you entertained. But honestly, in the end, check out The Little Sleep. Like I said, if you're expecting a horror novel, you're going to be very disappointed. But if you're expecting a fun twist on the detective story, then this is a fun twist for you. So thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you around next time.